الحديث الرابع والأربعون،
حديث 44.
عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال
From أبي هريرة may Allah be pleased with him who said
قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم
رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said
إذا مات العبد
If the servant passes away, dies
انقطع عمله إلا من ثلاث
The reward of his deeds will cease and stop except for three
صدقة جارية
A continuous charity
أو علم ينتفع به
knowledge that by which people benefit from
أو ولد صالح يدعو له
or a righteous child that makes دعاء for him
رواه الإمام مسلم
narrated by إمام مسلم
أبو هريرة مر كثيرا
أبو هريرة passed many times may Allah be pleased with him
الأصل أن الإنسان في الدنيا يعمل
the principle is that the son of Adam he would work in this worldly life
ويتزود منها للدار الآخرة
and he would take a provision from this worldly life to the next life
فإن عمل خيرا وجد خيرا
if he does good he will get good
وإن عمل شرا وجد شرا
and if he did evil he will find evil in the next life
وإذا مات الإنسان
and if the human passes away he dies
لا يمكن أن يستدرك بعد ذلك
he cannot catch up with doing anything anymore after his death
فإذا قال رب ارجعون
any good deeds so if he says oh my lord bring me back to the worldly life that is
قيل له كلا
he will be told definitely not
فلا يتمكن العبد إذن أن يزيد من حسناته
So the servant, the human, he cannot increase of his good deeds after his death.
ولا يمكنه أن يمحو شيئا من سيئاته.
And he cannot erase any of his evil deeds.
وانقطع عمله تماما.
And his deeds have ceased and stopped completely.
ثم جاء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم واستثنى هذه الأمور الثلاثة.
Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم here he made an exception for these three matters.
لأنها وإن لم تكن من عمله
because they are even if they are not of his own actions
لأن عمله انتهى بموته
because his actions stopped by his death
إلا إنها من آثار عمله
except that they are from the effects and the traces of his actions
فالأول الصدقة الجارية
the first is the continuous charity
والمقصود بالصدقة الجارية المستمر نفعها.
What is meant by continuous charity is the one that the benefit of it is still going on and continuous.
كالوقف.
Like the endowment.
والوقف يكون في أشياء كثيرة.
The endowment can be in many things.
لكن بشرط أن هذه الأشياء ينتفع بها ويبقى أصلها.
With the condition that those things people continue to benefit from and the origin of it the base of it still exists
كالعقار
like a land or a building
الآنية
like vessels or pots
الكتب
books
المصاحف
the books of the Quran
المساجد
the mosques
المدارس
the schools
البيوت
homes
السيارات
cars
وغيرها
And other than that.
المهم أن يبقى أصلها فلذلك لا يصح وقف الطعام
So the base continues to stay and remain That's why you cannot endow food for instance
لأنه إما أن يؤكل وإما أن يفسد
The food either it will be eaten or it will go bad and
لأنه إذا لم يؤكل لم ينتفع به
If it wasn't eaten no one will benefit from
وإذا
it
وإذا انتفع به لا ينتفع به إلا بالأكل
And if you benefit from it you cannot benefit except by eating it, consuming it.
إذا لن يبقى.
So it's gone, it's not gonna stay.
إلا إذا وقفنا مزرعة يعني
Except if we, for instance, we endow a farm, then it will continue to bring crops.
للمزرعة وليس للطعام.
So the endowment is the land, the farm, not the food.
أو وقف أشجار كالنخيل وغيره.
Or you endow trees like palm trees and the likes of that.
فهذه كلها أجرها مستمر لمن أوقفها.
So All of these things, the reward of them is continuous for those who endowed these matters.
خاصة إذا كانت هذه الأوقاف على أشياء يحبها الله وينتفع بها الناس.
Especially if these endowments were regarding things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves and the people benefit from them.
كالوقف على العلم والعبادة.
Like endowments for knowledge, Islamic knowledge and knowledge and ibadah act worship.
الثاني الذي يستمر أثره بعد موت الإنسان.
The second matter that the good effect of it continues after the death.
قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم علم ينتفع به.
He said عليه الصلاة والسلام knowledge by which it is benefited from.
والانتفاع به إما بأنه نشره بين الناس.
They benefit from it either because he spread it between the people.
أو كتب صنفها.
Or books that he authored.
أو تلاميذ علمهم.
Or students that he taught.
فهذا أجره مستمر.
So the reward of this is continuous.
مع استمرار هذه الكتب والتلاميذ الذين يعلمون وهكذا.
With these books continuing to stay and these students continuing to teach.
والآن ترون مثلا يعني مثال بسيط فقط يعني.
You could see now it's a very simple example for this.
هذا الكتاب الذي نقرأه.
This book that we are studying.
ألفه الشيخ عبد العلامة عبد الرحمن بن ناصر السعدي.
The Sheikh العلامة عبد الرحمن بن ناصر السعدي, he authored this book.
قبل أكثر من 70 سنة.
More than 70 years ago he authored.
ونحن نقرأه ونستفيد منه.
Here we are reading it and we are benefiting from.
فهذا علم ينتفع به.
This is knowledge that is benefited from.
صور الآن كتاب رياض الصالحين للإمام النووي رحمه الله.
Imagine now the book رياض الصالحين Gardens of Righteous by Imam النووي.
وهذا الكتاب قد كتب الله له من الانتشار شيء عظيم جدا.
And this book Allah عز وجل has destined for it to be widespread so much.
هو وتفسير ابن كثير.
Both that book and the tafsir of Imam Ibn Kathir.
ولعلهما أخلصهما في أخلص فيهما أشد الإخلاص.
And maybe the reason is that they were so much sincere in authoring these books.
وكتب كثيرة حقيقة يعني ألف أهل العلم وما زالت يتداولها الناس ويدعون لهم ولو لم يدعوا لهم فالله يأجرهم على هذا.
Many books that are in the same way still people are widespread between the people and the people read them and make dua for them and even if they don't make dua for them Allah عز وجل will reward them for these efforts.
والثالث الذي يستمر أثره بعد موت الإنسان.
The third thing that the good effect of it continues after the death of the person.
هو الولد الصالح الذي يدعو له.
The righteous child that makes دعاء for him.
سواء كان هذا الولد مباشر أو ابن.
Child is direct or the son of his son.
أو ابن بنت.
Or the son of a daughter.
المهم من ذريته.
Is from his progeny. That's the, what matters.
فالأب ينتفع بصلاحه ودعائه.
The father he benefits from his righteousness and his dua supplication.
فهو دائما يقول رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا.
So this child continues always to say, Oh Allah, have mercy on them like they raised me when I was little.
فإذا استجاب الله دعاءه.
If Allah answers his dua.
رحمهما.
Allah Azza wa Jal will have mercy on them both.
ورفع درجتهما.
And He will raise their level.
وكفر عنهما خطاياهما.
And He will wash away and expiate for their sins.
فإذا الحسنات مستمرة.
So the حسنات, the good deeds are continuous.
والسيئات مستمر دفعها.
And the evil deeds, they're erasing and they're going away is continuous also. They continue to be erased.
وجميع ما يصل العبد من آثار عمله ثلاثة.
And all of what the servant receives from the effects of his deeds, there are three matters.
الأول.
First.
أمور عمل بها الغير بسببه وبدعوته وتوجيهه.
Matters that others are doing because he called them to it, because he guided them and directed them to do them.
مثل قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من سن سنة حسنة فله أجرها.
Like the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the one who starts or initiates a good habit or a good sunnah, a good way, then he will have its reward and the reward of the ones who do it.
كمن يوجه الناس إلى صلاة الضحى.
Like the one who directs the people to pray duha.
أو إلى صيام ثلاثة أيام.
Or to fast 3 days.
أو دائما يذكرهم بالصدقة.
Or he always reminds them of charity.
أو بطلب العلم.
Or to seek knowledge.
أو بالإحسان إلى الجار.
Or to be kind to the neighbors.
أو بغير ذلك. المهم يستفيدون استفادوا من توجيهه ودعوته.
They benefited. The point is they benefited from his direction, his guidance, and his inviting them to do those good deeds.
الثاني انتفع بها الغير باقتدائه به في الخير.
The second part, the others benefited from him by taking him as a role model and an example to follow.
فيكون كذلك سن سنة حسنة واقتدى الناس به.
Likewise, he would have been from those who initiated a good way or a good habit, and the people took that way and followed it.
ولذلك نكثر دائما من قراءة سير الصالحين.
This is why we should always read a lot in the biographies of the righteous people.
فإذا قرأت سيرة أحد الصالحين ثم اقتديت به.
So if you read the biography of one of the righteous people, then you took him as an example to follow.
فإنه ينتفع بهذا الاقتداء.
Then he would benefit from you taking him as an example.
لأنه هو السبب في ذلك.
Because he is the cause behind that.
الأمر الثالث الذي ينتفع به.
The third matter that you benefit from.
هذا ما يهدى إليه من الغير.
That what is given to him as a gift from the others.
سواء صدقة صدق به عنه.
Whether it is a charity that was given on his behalf.
يعني مثال.
Example.
أنا جئت الآن وتصدقت بصدقة.
Now I come and I give a donation.
وقلت اللهم اجعلها لفلان رجل مات من 10 سنوات 20 أقل أكثر بغض النظر لكنه مات.
And I say, oh Allah, make this sadaqa that I gave on behalf of so and so. He could have died 10 years or whatever, but I make it on his behalf.
أو دعا له في ظهر الغيب.
Or you make dua for him when he is absent.
سواء كان هذا المتصدق أو الداعي من أولاده أو من غير أولاده.
Whether this one giving the donation or making the dua was from one's children or not.
وأذكر أنه حدثنا الشيخ شيخنا الشيخ صالح البليهي رحمه الله تعالى.
I remember that one of our شيوخ, the Sheikh Saleh Al-Balehi, he told us.
لما سألناه عن إهداء الثواب للآخرين من الدعاء وغيره.
When we asked him about giving deeds as gifts for the others, whether it was دعاء or otherwise.
يقول كان عندنا في البلد.
He said we used to have in our town.
مجموعة من الأصدقاء.
A group of friends.
كبار السن.
Old in age.
مات أحدهم.
One of them passed away.
فقام أحد هؤلاء الأحياء.
So one of those living who remained alive, they came and
فسبح بيده 100 تسبيحة.
He made with his hand 100 تسبيحة سبحان الله.
و100 تحميد و100 تكبيرة.
100 الحمد لله 100 الله أكبر.
ثم قال اللهم اجعل ثوابها لفلان.
Then he said, oh Allah, make the reward of this for so and so, the person who passed away, their friend that passed away.
يقول فلما نام.
So when he went to sleep.
رآه في المنام.
He saw him in his dream.
وقال جزاك الله خيرا.
And he said to him, may Allah reward you.
وصلت الهدية.
The gift has reached. The present has reached me.
وهذا وإن كان مناما لا ينبني عليه حكم.
Although this is a dream, we don't take any ruling from it.
لكن كما قال الإمام أحمد رحمه الله تعالى.
But as Imam Ahmad said, may Allah have mercy on him.
رؤيا المؤمن.
The vision of a believer.
تسره ولا تغره.
It makes him happy and it does not deceive him.
فالقصد أن هذا الإهداء ينفع الميت.
The point is that this kind of giving it as a gift, this kind of gifting, it benefits the dead.
كذلك من تخرج بتعليمه أو من جيرانه أو أصحابه ودعوا له أو تصدقوا عنه كل هذا ينفعه إن شاء الله تعالى.
Likewise from the students, from the neighbors, from friends, those who do anything for him, they give it as a gift, it will benefit him إن شاء الله.
والقصد أن العبد قد يجتمع يعني فيه عدة أمور تنفع الناس.
The intention here is that the servant of Allah, maybe few things gathered together in him ينتفع بها الناس. نعم. By which the people benefit. نعم. From.
يعني الآن لو كان لك ولد صالح.
So now if you have a child who is a righteous child.
فهذا ولد صالح يدعو لك.
So this is a righteous child that makes dua for you.
وأنت قد علمته العلم النافع.
And you taught him beneficial knowledge.
فهذا أيضا علم ينتفع به.
So this is now knowledge that is benefited from.
وأوقفت له كتبا أو أوقفه كتبا.
And you endowed for him books or he endowed books of knowledge.
فهذا أيضا علم ينتفع به.
So this is now knowledge that is benefited from.
فجمعت الأمور الثالثة في ولدك.
So you gathered together the three matters in just one in your child.
فيسعى الواحد منا.
So let one of us should strive and labor
أن يوصل الخير إلى أولاده
to make goodness reach his children.
لأن نفعه على المدى الطويل يعود إليه.
Because the benefit on the long run actually goes back to him.
والله أعلم.
And Allah knows best.